Data can either stored in file systems or database systems, and we can choose to have SQL or non-SQL based on the requirement considering multiple parameters. Today in this video, we will try to understand this in detail and know what is the difference between these. Before proceeding, if you are in a learning path about data and haven't yet subscribed for this channel, please do like and share and press bell button for instant notifications. So we will start by understanding what is SQL, and then we will see what is no SQL so that we can see the actual difference. So coming to the SQL, so SQL is nothing but it is a relational database where we typically have for example MySQL, Oracle, Microsoft SQL Server, IBM DB2, Vertica like databases, and usually it will be having a foreign keys. So foreign key will be referring to the primary keys, and that will enable the relationship. So that's the reason we call it as a relational database. And other thing is, like, it will be having a uniform schema. That means there will be a fixed number of columns, and all the records will be having the same columns and same data types, which is shared across the table. The SQL will allow the vertical scaling. When we say vertical scaling, it is the increase of the horsepower. So horsepower may be increase in the RAM, or it might be increase in CPU, or disk input outputs, that we call it as a disk IOPS. And we can increase the video card capacity, network card capacity of our existing machine. So here we are not increasing the machines, number of machines, we are just adding the horsepower of the existing machine. So this might this may be at a on-prem or a virtual or a cloud hosted solution. SQL can either be hosted in virtual cloud or it can be in a on-prem solution. And other difference is it follows ACID transaction thing, but atomicity, consistency, isolation and durability. So that we call it as a ACID transaction, and this will usually happen when we have a typical transactions data coming into a database. And we use a SQL like programming language. Might be the data, as we said, there might be different databases that we are using, but how do we query or how do we use the data for any reporting or any dashboard purposes using a SQL like programming language. So this is about SQL, and let's go for NoSQL, where we will see what is NoSQL and how it can differ from SQL. So in case of NoSQL, so it is designed for scale. So how it is designed is, it is the design itself is enabling the scale. So we will see how it will enable the scaling. But before that, what are the best example for NoSQL databases is MongoDB, CosmosDB, IBM Domino's, and Redis. So these are the databases which supports NoSQL. And it is a dynamic schema. So this is the main difference when we see in the SQL and NoSQL. In SQL, it is just a fixed schema, and each columns and each rows should have a specific column names and data type which is predefined. But here in the NoSQL, so each row and each row can have a different column, different data types, entirely a different structure each row can have, and that's we call it as a it is best ideal solution to store semi-structured or unstructured data. And since it is a dynamic schema, so we can use it for, I mean, it's very flexible when we are getting the variety of data in. So this is the best solution in that scenario as well. And here in NoSQL, it allows the horizontal scaling. That means we can vertically scale also, but NoSQL is designed for horizontal scaling. That is what it is meant for, that we can have adding the multiple compute nodes. So adding the multiple compute nodes is nothing but horizontal scaling. That means we are not increasing the capacity of our existing machine here. So we are just adding multiple nodes basically, or multiple machines, and that will enable the distributed computing. And this is a kind of a cheaper option when we want to scale with the multiple options, when we see what vertical scaling and horizontal scaling. And when we are talking about a big data scenario, so horizontal scaling is more cheaper. So that's the reason, in that case we have to choose NoSQL, which supports the horizontal scaling. And so NoSQL will support there is a Brewer's cap theorem, which talk about consistency, availability and partition tolerance. That means it is more consistent and available, and it allows the partition tolerance when we talk about the big data and the data which is more semi-structured and unstructured format. And this kind of data is processed using a programming languages like Python, R, Spark and Scala. So basically we cannot query just by using a SQL kind of programming languages. So with that, we will just see a note which is important to conclude this video. So SQL is not designed for basically for horizontal scaling, and that is a limitation of it. So that's the reason we use or we choose to use NoSQL when the data volume is huge and there is a big data scenarios. And also advantage of using horizontal scaling, especially in case of cloud hosted storages, is so we can choose to have a auto scaling up and auto scaling down. So by doing that, so we can store save the cost. So when the data is volume is huge, we can enable the auto scale up, and when it is down, we can enable auto scale down. So that will help save the cost as per the requirement. So hope this video was useful. Thanks for watching.